Hey SnowRunner fans, in this video we're going to take a look at the Scout ZikZ5368, handy name. If you enjoy this video, please take a moment to subscribe, like and share. Thank you. So as I said, we're looking at the Scout ZikZ5368, and this is an interesting little truck. This is an off-road truck, but it's very tiny, actually. I'm showing you the way that I've customized it, and you can see its settings. It's got a S plus A and B plus ratings, along with a decent enough size gas tank for its size. So you'll see that even though this is a small off-road truck, it's only got four wheels, for example, it is a spunky little truck with lots of power for its size. You can see I'm making it tow a two-slot flatbed through the mud. And even though I'm leaving the diff lock off, it's doing an admirable job with just the all-wheel drive on. Make it through the mud here, turn around. Head back out. Oh, a little slippy there, a little slippy there. And we're just about done. Yeah, it's even got a spunky little horn. Alright, so from the mud pit, we'll head on over to the quarry outside of Smithville Dam. And we're still hauling that same two-slot flatbed. You'll see how the Scout ZikZ5368 handles the quarry with the small trailer behind it. So for the moment, we're leaving it in automatic with the all-wheel drive on. We're going to have to make a small detour to get enough room to head down the shortcut. Here we go. Let's turn this truck around. The truck and trailer, actually, because if it was just the truck, it wouldn't need any help at all. It would just turn down this shortcut. So tiny. Again, tiny truck though, lots of spunk. See, it's holding that small trailer down, no worries. See how it handles the rest of the quarry. Especially the ride up and out of here. I must say though, it's handling itself pretty well considering it's solely an all-wheel drive. I really like the looks of this little truck too. It's got the twin intakes coming up over the roof. Very cool looking. Spare wheel in the back. Are we going to take the shortcut? Flip a coin. Do it quick. Yes, no, yes, no. Yes, we're going to take the shortcut. Of course we are. Does the spunky truck have enough power? It sure does. And it's hauling that two-slot flatbed along behind it like it doesn't even count. I don't know why, but I always seem to bump that wall on the way up and out of here. I've got to take a better look at my driving around that spot. So, any moment now, we'll be upon the shortcut. Same when we came down, we're going to turn around and go back up. Here it is here, just on the left. Is the trailer going to give this little truck a hard time? I'm going to go with no. seems to be handling itself quite well. Throw it in low so we can add the diff lock. And it'll haul itself and the trailer up out of here nicely. This is a really powerful little truck, I must say. I can certainly see myself taking it out on some missions. Not big heavy-duty ones, of course, but look at him go up that hill in automatic. That's perfect. That's great. Once more on the spunky horn. Good stuff. All right, so now from the quarry, we head off to the Yukon and the strong currents. We're still hauling that two-slot flatbed behind us. And little trucks, especially with trailers, it's a toss-up when they hit the current or when the current hits them. Doesn't like the diff lock being on. Shut it off real quick. We're gonna turn that diff lock back on though real quick to just to haul us out of here the last little bit. Turn it off once we get out. Have no problem hauling the trailer out behind us. And we're done. If you find this video helpful or entertaining, I'd appreciate it if you could take a moment and hit subscribe, like, and share. And in the meantime, take care of yourself and stay safe. Until the next video, bye for now.